Hello. Today we are going to discuss about the bonding in kerosene. Kerosene molecule is a sandwiched structure of center ion. It obeys the EAN rule, that is, total valence electron is satisfy the nearest noble gas configuration. For example, here ion is Fe2 plus, it is having 26 electron, 2 cyclopentadiene, each one donates 5 electron, totally 10 electron. This total EAN is, that is effective atomic number rule, as per the rule, it having the 36 electron, it attain the nearest noble gas configuration, so it is more stable, it have in crystalline as well as gaseous form. In the ferrocene molecule, the cyclopentadienyl is present, that is, each carbon of the cyclopentadienyl is contributed to bonding with metal. There is a confusion in the structural property of the cyclopentadienyl and cyclopentadiene. Cyclopentadiene is a 4 electron donor, there is hepto nomenclature, it is a 4 hepto. Cyclopentadienyl is a 5 hepto, it is a 5 electron donor. In ferrocene molecule, the cyclopentadienyl ring is present. It donates 5 electron to the entire ion system. So each one 5 electron, totally donates 10 electron. Ferrocene type molecules obey the general rules developed for the carbonyls. For carbonyls, that is metal carbonyls, the bonding mechanisms we are discussed in the form of synergic mechanism, that is, ligand donates electron to the metal, form a sigma bond. If metal having higher electron density, it back donates to the pi star orbital of the carbonyl carbon, that is, form sigma and bi bonding. Sigma bonding enhances bi bonding, bi bonding enhances sigma bonding, both are possible. That is a synergic mechanism in metal carbonyl. In ferrocene also the similar phenomena is present, but it can be clearly understood by molecular orbitals diagram. The properties of molecular orbital of the pi system of cyclic polyenes may be summarized here. There is a single orbital at lowest energy that consists of an unbroken, that is, nodeless, of electron density above and below the plane of the ring. That means now the principal axis passing through the center of the cyclopentadienyl ring. Above and below the ring, there is electron density in uniform. At slightly higher energy, there is a doubly degenerate set of orbital, each of which has one nodal planes containing the principal axis passing through the cyclopentadienyl ring exactly off. That means it passing through one carbon of the cyclopentadienyl ring. In yet higher energy, another doubly degenerate set with two nodal planes. Each one nodal plane is exactly perpendicular to other. The increasing number of nodes will result molecular orbital with symmetries of sigma, pi and delta bonding. Sigma bonding formation, it is completely cylindrical symmetry. Pi, one nodal planes, delta, two nodal planes. The cyclopentadienyl of the ferrocene molecule having possible orbital arrangements if the carbon p orbital in zero node, that is lowest energy, it is single zero node. The orbitals are A1G and E2U. Their respective similar possible bonding is occur in the metal orbitals. Is here it is S and DZ square in the A1G, A2E in the PZ orbitals. Likewise, in the single node orbital, E1G and E1U orbital. The E1G symmetry orbital DYZ and E1G orbital, another one is DXZ. Similarly, for E1 u, that is py of the metal orbital, and pz of the metal orbitals. Then double node, that is two single node is in exactly perpendicular in position, it form e2g and e2u. e2g are the cyclopentadienyl, they are similar matching orbitals dxy, and another one is the dx square minus y square. For e2u there is no suitable orbitals available in the metal orbitals. From these symmetries we can generate the molecular orbitals. So bonding in ferrocene involve ligand as well as metal orbital. How these ligand group orbitals and metal group orbitals are first generated, then how it combine. Ferrocene, the 5p3 atomic orbitals of carbon on the planar C5H5 ring can combine to give 5 molecular orbitals. 1 zero node, 2 single node, 2 double node planar. These 5 groups molecular orbitals present on the 1 C5H5 group can combine in pairs, that is ferrocene ending 2 cyclopentadienyl ring with the similar set of 5 groups of MOs present on the another C5 group to give totally 10 ligand group orbitals, that is A1G, A2U, E1G, E1U, E2G, E2U, totally 10 ligand group orbital. In ferrocene, the central atom is iron, it have outer 4s and 3d z square atomic orbital with the A1G symmetry, 4pz orbital with the A2E symmetry, 4px and 4py with the E1U symmetry, 3d xz, 3d yz with the E1G symmetry, and finally 3d xy and 3d x square minus y square with the E2G symmetry notation, totally 8 atomic orbitals. So these 10 ligand group orbitals of the 2 cyclopentadienyl and 1 ion, 8 atomic orbitals involved in the bonding. So it can be represented in the form of pictorial. A zero node having the principal axis passing through the center of the cyclopentadienyl, A1 symmetry. Another one is here, the principal axis passing through the center of the cyclopentadienyl ring, that is passing through one carbon, it having like this E1. Another one is the one nodal planes passing exactly perpendicular each other, that is E2. So cyclopentadienyl having A1, E1 and E2 symmetries, their respective metal orbitals are here. From this it form sigma, pi and delta bonds. The sigma and pi delta bond formation, molecular pictorial representations here. The sigma bonding formation from the dz square, pi bonding from dxz and yz, and delta bonding formation from dx square minus y square and dxy orbital. Depending upon this sigma, dz square, pi xy and dyz, and delta x square and x square minus y square and xy orbital, it can be represented of pictorial form. A1g of the cyclopentadiene, their symmetry orbitals available by metal is s and dz square. Likewise a2u pz, pi bonding, that is e1g is similar orbital in the metal is dyz and dxz. E1U, their respective metal orbitals are PY and PZ, PX. Delta bonding formation, E2G, their respective metal orbital is DXY. Another E2G, DX square minus Y square. E2U, there is no similar orbitals not available in the metal side. So, the ferrocene molecule, it form a stable complex. The stability of the ferrocene molecule is explained through the molecular orbital diagram. So based on the energy of cyclopentadienyl of the 2 cyclopentadienyl ring and 1 ion atom, we are arranging atomic order of the ion on one side and energy of the cyclopentadienyl. Zero node A1G and E2. A2U and then single node E1G and E1U, E2G and E2U of the two nodal planes of the cyclopentadienyl of the ferrocene on one side according to the energy. Likewise, in the ion energy, d orbital, s orbital, p orbital and their symmetry energy orbitals are in the energy axis. Now we can combine these energies of energies and symmetries of cyclopentadienyl and ion atom. Generally, in molecular orbital diagram, if the energies and the symmetries are in exactly matches, then only a strong bond is formed. Otherwise, the bond formation is very little. It is not much contributed to the stability of the ferrocene molecule formation. Now we can select the A2U of the cyclopentadienyl, that is ligand side. The similar A2U is available in the metal side also, but metal side A2U is in higher energy, but A2U of the cyclopentadienyl is very lower in energy. So in the bonding formation, that is in the molecular orbital of the ferrocene, the contribution only from the ligand side. The A2U contribution is very little. So the contribution to the bonding in the molecular orbital of ferrocene is only to the ligand cyclopentadienyl, so interaction is very little. Another one is the A1G. A1G is the lowest zero nodal plane. Similar A1G is available in the metal side. So this A1G of the metal is very higher in energy, but A1G of the cyclopentadienyl is lowest energy. So in the ferrocene molecule formation, that is in the molecular orbital picture, the contribution to the ferrocene molecule is only from the ligand. The metal contribution is very little. Then next stage in higher energy, that is single nodal plane, E1G and E1U orbitals are available. E1U having the orbital in the ligand side, similarly E1U of the metal side is also available. But metal having the higher energy of the E1U, but E1U of the ligand is in lowest energy. So the lowest energy of the E1U is maximum contributed to the ferrocene molecular orbital contribution. The metal E1U contribution is very little. So the exact matching of each one is symmetry is okay, but the energy aspect, it is higher and lower. So little contributions are takes place in the ferrocene molecule formation. Then go to the E1G of the single nodal plane of the cyclopentadienyl. The E1G of cyclopentadienyl and E1G of the metal side almost in close energy. So symmetries as well as energies are very close to each other. It will form strong bonding as well as and their antibonding orbitals. Then next there is E2U and E2G of the cyclopentadienyl. E2U, so already we are discussing the picture of the symmetries and picture. E2U, there is no symmetry, orbitals are not available on the metal side, so it behave as a non-bonding orbitals. Then E2G of the cyclopentadienyl, it is in highest energy. The similar E2G is available in the metal side, but is in lowest energy, so the contribution is very lower or little interaction. So each orbital bonding as well as antibonding orbitals are occur in the molecular orbital of ferrocene molecule. So the only orbital E2 is the non-bonding orbitals. So the better stability or higher stability of the ferrocene molecule may be due to the bonding interaction between the cyclopentadienyl of the E1G as well as the metal E1G. It forms strong bonding orbital in the lowest energy. So higher stability of ferrocene molecule is due to the E1G orbital of the cyclopentadienyl and E1G of the metal form strong bonding. Then structure and bonding of the ferrocene and their similar metallocene series can also compare. So in between the two cyclopentadienyl, one metal ion is present, we are called as a ferrocene. The distance between the two ring is 3.32 angstrom unit. Because of the small distance, the steric hindrance occur between the two rings, so it is always occur in staggered configuration. But if you are selecting the higher metal like ruthenosine, rhodosine, osmosine, or some other heavier transient metal, means the distance between the two ring is increases, that is 3.68 and above angstrom unit, then the steric hindrance between these two rings are reduced. So it can, even in the solid state, it is possible in eclipsed configuration. Then physical properties of the ferrocene molecule. Ferrocene molecule is in diamagnetic in nature. Its smell is like a camphor, and a melting point 174 degrees centigrade, boiling point 249 degrees centigrade, and it sublimes at 100 degrees centigrade. Ferrocene is the most stable of all the metallocene and exceptionally stable and does not decompose up to 500 degrees centigrade. It is insoluble in water but dissolves in most organic solvent. It is unaffected by air, not easily air oxidized, but it is also stable towards hydrolysis due to absence of ionic bonding. It is readily oxidized by some of the salt like silver ion, iodine, ferric chloride and dilute nitric acid to give ferromagnetic of blue ferrocenium ion. This large size cation is precipitated by large size anion like I3-, Br3-, SpCl6-, BF4-, etc. In solid state, ferrocene exists in the form of staggered configuration, but in the gas phase, it is having the possibility of eclipsed configuration because of free rotation is available in between the metal ion and the cyclopentadienyl ring. The internal rotation of the two ring is possible with minimum energy of 4 plus or minus 1 kilojoules per mole. From the X-ray and the neutron diffraction studies, we can confirm this process. The rotation between these two is minimum energy and possible to tilt is only 9 degree. Since the barrier of internal rotation is very small, the rotation angle between the two rings is 9 degree rather than the 0 degree for precessional eclipse. Therefore, ferrocene exists as nearly eclipse in the gas phase. It is also observed that at a temperature of 298 Kelvin, there is a rotation of the ring even in the solid state. All the CC bond in length are equal and the ion is the equidistance from all the carbon of cyclopentadienyl ring. The ruthenosine and osmosine have eclipse ring similar to ferrocene in gas phase because it having the higher distance in between the two ring. Suppose for example a derivative of ferrocene, that is decamethyl ferrocene, the substitution is a heavier mass, the rotation is not easily possible. So either these type of substituents present in both, either in gaseous phase or in the solid state, it is always exist in the form of the staggered configuration. Ferrocene gives one H1 NMR signal because all hydrogens are in the same environment and are equivalent. Ferrocene is not a fluxional molecule. So H1 NMR of ferrocene molecule give at a peak 4.4 pm because all the hydrogen having same environment. Ferrocene behaves as a Lewis base, and therefore on placing in strong acid, Fe2 plus gets protonated. The signal in H1 NMR spectrum of the solution at the delta 2.1 ppm shows the presence of metal hydride. Fe2 plus centers of ferrocene is oxidized in strong acid medium to form Fe3 plus. Some of the applications of the ferrocene. Ferrocene and its derivatives have many applications because of the redox properties of the ion and the fact that cyclopentadienyl rings can be derivatized. Some important applications of ferrocene and its derivatives are as a liquid hydrocarbon fuel additive. Its addition of an addition to diesel fuel reduces smoke emission and increases fuel economy. And it also acts as an electron transfer catalyst. And it also acts as a biosensor and also as a UV observer. That's all about the bonding in ferrocene. Thanks.